Member for Bonnie.
Thank you, Madam Deputy Speaker. Tonight in this House, I am calling for a science centre to be included in the Gold Coast Health and Knowledge Precinct at Southport. I love science, so I've got a degree in it. Science opens the minds to see the world for all its potential. A strong education in science increases critical thinking and analytical skills. It's important for success across all aspects of life. The Gold Coast is the only major city in Australia without a science centre. Sydney, Melbourne, Brisbane, Adelaide and Perth all have their own hands-on interactive science centres, as does Newcastle, Canberra and Wollongong. We're one of the fastest growing regions in the country, with bigger populations than some of those cities, and we are missing out. I've talked about this at length with my good friends Professor Richard John and Randall Hall from Griffith's Science on the Go. Since launching in 2005, their programs have won awards and engaged over 500,000 people in STEM education initiatives. They run hands-on science experiences across the Gold Coast, Logan and northern New South Wales, driving many young people to take the next step and study at Griffith's Gold Coast campus. They share my passion for STEM, and their work shows there is a public demand for such a centre. The Health and Knowledge Precinct is missing a public face like this, somewhere to engage our community with the huge scale of what it is trying to achieve for our city. If you ask most people in the area, even people living in the neighbouring suburbs, what the Gold Coast Health and Knowledge Precinct is, many of them would have no idea. We need locals to engage with this space to help make it a success. The whole idea of it is to use the collaboration and proximity of Griffith University and the two hospitals to encourage scientific innovation and entrepreneurialism. A science centre would align perfectly with those aims of the precinct. My vision would be land provided by the state government, funding from the federal government to help get it established, and a commitment from Griffith University to have their staff run the centre. If land is not a possibility, we could use the existing Nexus Way building owned by the state as a trial site, or it could be placed in the ground level of Griffith's soon-to-be-built ADAPT building. This could be a place where all our local schools visit regularly on excursions. That alone would mean thousands of constant visitors to the centre. They won't have to drive up to Brisbane anymore to get this sort of science education. It would be a great resource for local teachers. It would generate more tourism and local jobs. I urge the government to do everything it can to establish a science centre on the Gold Coast. Our kids deserve to have every possible opportunity in science, and this would make that a reality.
Thank you, Member for Bonnie. I call the Member for...